a delight for me to be here and participate together with senior management staff of the FCTA in the activities of this workshop, intended to look very closely at the real estate development in the Federal Capital Territory in a bid to improve it and also ensure that it meets the needs of the residents of the territory. Permit me to begin by once again expressing the appreciation of the FCT administration to the Speaker of the House of Representatives, the Right Honourable Deputy Speaker, the leadership of the House for setting up this ad hoc committee to investigate the operations of the real estate developers in the Federal Capital Territory, and also particularly for the appointment of Honourable Blessing Onu to chair the committee. I wish to commend Honourable Onu for the zeal and commitment with which she has pursued her assignment, but this is not surprising for us here at the FCT, because she displayed the same passion for matters that directly affect the people when she served many years ago as the Secretary for Social Development in the Federal Capital Territory Administration. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, shelter is the third most fundamental need of man, coming closely after food and clothing, and access to decent accommodation is often considered as a fundamental human right. In a fast-growing city such as Abuja and its ever-increasing human population, there will always be the need to meet the shelter needs of all categories of people who have chosen to reside here. Over the years, various strategies were evolved to meet the rising accommodation needs of the residents of the FCT, starting, of course, with the government's construction of the first set of residential accommodation for civil servants, I think in Garki Area 1, and in fact in Gwagwalada and even some parts of Suleja. These were eventually sold off to occupants under the Sale of Government Houses program, thus giving many Nigerians the opportunity to own their own homes in the nation's capital. The FCT administration subsequently introduced the mass housing scheme to be driven by the private sector after it became apparent that government alone could not possibly meet the shelter needs of the citizenry. While this policy enabled many to own or rent decent accommodation, it also came with its own challenges, some of which have been enunciated by the Honorable Chairman of this ad hoc committee in her speech a short while ago, hosting the ad hoc committee in the FCT headquarters on 10th of December 2021. You will, for instance, find beautiful mansions and well-built estates with no access, and estates being constructed in violation of some of these demands. These are some of the challenges, but quite frankly, I wish to further reiterate that the way to go is still the private sector involvement in partnership with the public sector under strong regulation. I know in the speech of the Honorable Chairman of this committee and maybe some of the other utterances, we seem to be feeling that we have no way out. But I personally believe working together under, of course, the leadership of your committee and the recommendations you are going to proffer, it is still not too late for us to recover lost ground. Over expansion, weak supervision, overpopulation, and all these other factors led us to where we are. But we have no option but to work together under the right laws and regulations that are relevant for the day we are today. And I'm sure with that we should be able to do it. I personally feel what will help us through is strong enforcement of the laws and regulations, which obviously, as was earlier indicated in the speech by the Honorable Chairman of the Ad Hoc Committee, we are not lacking. So having said that, despite the challenges, we recognize that the public-private partnership is still the most viable option available to us in meeting housing challenges. And that is why, looking into the future, we have commenced the land for infrastructure swap program in one of our districts, that is the Gwagwa district. And subsequently, others will also come up under very strict regulations that protects the estate investor, protects the government, and protects the off-takers, as well as those financing the projects along the entire value chain. I've taken time to go through the various stages of the housing development in the FCT during the last few years. And also, actually, the theme of this workshop really is very, very apt. And that, of course, is the journey so far, the gains, the pitfalls, and the future. And I personally is convinced that getting the right synergy between all parties involved will get it right. It's just a matter of time and, of course, hard work. Judging from the distinguished personalities and organizations in attendance at this workshop this morning, it is our expectation that its outcome will further help us in our quest for further strengthening the housing development sector in the FCT and make it more responsive to the needs of the people. And that is why all the relevant heads of departments and agencies that are within the housing construction value chain are all here, and they are going to be here for the entire period of this two-day workshop. It is on this note, therefore, I wish you all a very rewarding and productive convergence while waiting eagerly to be guided by the recommendations of this committee. Thank you for your valuable